I think we need to calmly step back and maybe look at Trump in a different context. He is America's, our own American war criminal, of a kind we've never experienced before.
You just said war criminal. What do you mean, war criminal?
I did. Well, in international law, there have been, quote, crimes against humanity. I think what we're talking about, Trump's crimes as an American war criminal in his own country that he has perpetrated upon our people, including the tens of thousands of people who died because of his homicidal negligence in the pandemic, putting his own electoral interests above the health of our people as they were slaughtered in this pandemic, looking at his actions in terms of fomenting a coup to hold on to office, in which the head of the American military, the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, has now compared Trump, not the press, not reporters comparing Trump to Hitler, but rather the head of the American military comparing him and his movement to brown shirts, to the Reichstag fire. This is a huge wake-up call to this country when General Milley, the head of the American military, has said this. And it fits as a piece with something so extraordinary in our history. It's not political. Trump is not just political. He transcends the political, and we need to start looking at his crimes in that context.
You're going to get heat for talking about war crimes because there's, you know, it's not as if the ICC is setting up a panel or anything, taking any action.
I want to be careful in using and trying to say we need a new context, a war against both our people in terms of what the effects of his policies and selfishness, if you want to use the word narcissism, brought. Okay, it is something in itself that we have never seen in a president before. It's not about just impeachable offenses. It's about a different kind of crime in which the humanity of the people of the United States was relegated to the floor by the President of the United States, who uplifted only his own narrow political, financial, and personal interest above that of our people, of our country, of our Constitution. All I'm doing is saying, whoa, let's look at Trump's crimes in a different context. Yes, war crimes. These were crimes against our people.